New Jerusalem, we were visiting the kingdom of Persia in space in the second heaven, when we stood above a mountain in this realm of the enemy. I saw in the horizon, as far as the eyes can see, a world of great light that was shining like mirror and crystal. It was really flashing bright light. I saw mansion of light in this glorious city. I was overwhelmed with the greatness and glory of this celestial world. I asked the two angel, "What is this majestic world of light that is beaming glory and light?" The radiant angels told me, "This is the New Jerusalem, the bride of the Word. We are going there." I was so joyful to behold this eternal world of light and glory that flashes bright light. I could not wait. I told the angels, "You are moving so slow," and I was running. I left the angels behind me. These angels of light were laughing. They said, "You have now seen how great is the celestial kingdoms of God." Ignoring them, I ran as fast as I could, and when we arrived I beheld this glorious heavenly kingdom. I don't know how to describe the architecture of this city whose builder is God himself. I saw that the eternal kingdom of light was of square shape. This sparkling city of light had 12 great entrances or gateways, leading into this heavenly world that glitter. In each side of the square there was 3 gateways. In the east there were 3 gateway, likewise in the west, the north and the south side. Upon each of the 12 gate of the city it was written, "Faith, patience and perseverance. Here is the patience of the saints, here are they that keep the commandments of God, and the faith of Jesus." I asked the angel, "What is the meaning of these words?" The Lord angels told me, "This is the New Jerusalem, built with precious stone that are transparent like mirror." I tried to touch and I saw that it was not mirror but precious and transparent stones. The angel told me, "This is what the Lord has prepared for the church. You must obey and keep his word in order to enter. Have you noticed that the city is square? This is because the builder of the city has a square heart. In order to live for eternity in this city of light you must have a square heart." I ask the angels, "What do you mean?" The angel told me, "A square has equal side. You must have a good heart. Remove from your heart animosity, conflict and hate. A square does not move, for when it moves it's no longer a square, it becomes another shape. You need a clean white heart. You can be a woman of integrity without sin. Change your heart." The angel told me, "The king of this celestial world has a transparent heart, for his inside is exactly like his outside. The way he is in his heart is the way he is outside, for he is not an hypocrite. It's only people whose heart are transparent that will inherit the kingdom of heaven, not the hypocrite, who are serving God but in their heart they have anger, unforgiveness, hate and animosity. This is why these celestial precious stones are transparent. You must be white and clean." I asked the Lord angels, "Why are there 12 gateways in this eternal city?" The angels told me, "Number 12 is the number of foundation, and this city foundation is Jesus Christ himself." I asked the Lord angels, "Why is it written, 'Faith, patience and perseverance' on each gate of the city?" The angel told me, "You got to know that the king of this kingdom of light is a man of prayer. He has a lot of faith, and when people commit sin, he is patient, enduring in his heart people evil action, for he has long suffering and patience waiting for you to repent from your sin. When he was on earth he prayed with perseverance. In order to enter the eternal city you must be a woman of faith. You must be patient and learn to endure in your heart wrongdoing, and you must persevere and never give up, otherwise it is impossible to enter." Beloved, when we enter the New Jerusalem I was lost in wonder and delight. This earth that many are attached to is garbage in comparison of the everlasting city of light. All the building and the mansions in New Jerusalem shone with great light. From far I saw the street of gold that seems like rivers, but at close look it seems like oil. When I touched them it was solid gold. The angels told me, "It's not oil but gold that is pure, though it seems to be liquid. All the street were gold." I said, "This seems slippery, I will fall." The angels said, "It won't happen. When we walk in the city we came across a huge crystal river. Its crystalline water was blue." I told the angels of the Lord, "Such blue river, I have never seen this before. Will it be blue when I touch it?" The angels laughed and told me, "Get some and see for yourself." When I took some of it in my hand, I saw that it had become transparent, like crystal. The angel told me, This pure water is the word of God, for this city is founded on the word that is pure and original, the word that is not mixed but sound. The blue color of the crystal water symbolizes the truth. As we move along this limpid river, I saw a tree in the middle of this river of life, and its leaves were evergreen. The tree was inside an enclosure upon which I saw 12 stars, but outside the enclosure they were 7 stars. Since I wanted to know about number, the Lord angels told me, number 1 represents seeking and knowing God in totality. If you want to be a powerful instrument in the hand of the Lord, seek to know God in totality. You need total commitment, for the Lord is available. Number 2 represents separation, division and isolation from the world and the enemy. You must separate from the world, its trend. You must end association with the world. You must do an exchange with the devil, giving him back all that belong to him. You must get rid of the property of the enemy. This is the doctrine of separation and exclusion from the world. On the second day of creation, God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. Number 3 is change. If you seek God in totality and you separate from the world, change will be evident. Number 4 is the power of God. When you seek God in totality and you have separated from the world and has changed, you will receive power and oil will flow. The gift of the Spirit will manifest. Number 5 is the hand of the Lord, that you will see as a result of separation from sinful life. When you apply these previous principles, you will see the hand of the Lord. Number 6 is deliverance, and number 7 is perfection and rest. When you live sanctifying yourself, you will sleep peacefully. The number 7 tell how God preparing the church which must go through this 7 step, for the Lord is cleaning his bride, clothing his bride, preparing her for the rapture. We are not entering New Jerusalem shapeless. We are already taking the stature and shape of this city which is square on earth. You will be raptured only after going through a process leading to perfection. Jesus' light will light the city. In this eternal world, your husband will call you sister, and your own son will call you sister. There will be no marriage, no birth and no death. You shall have glorified and incorruptible body of angels. You shall recognize your mother and loved ones, but they will become simply your brother and sister. Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the former things have passed away. After visiting the tree of life, I was led by the 2 angels to the 12 gate of the city. Each gate represent condition in order to become the bride of the word. When the first gate opened, I saw a beautiful lady dressed in white. She had a crown of 12 stars on the head. She stood above the sun, and she was enveloped with a rainbow. I told the angel, "You said there is no one in the New Jerusalem, but who is this woman?" The angels told me, "The woman you see is the image of the bride. Her shining garment is her good works of love and affection and charity. She would be known by her kind and sweet action. Many claim that they are going up to the rapture, but they have evil heart full of anger, bitterness and conflict. They are not the bride, they are prisoner of Satan. You see the beautiful sandal of this bride. This is the word of God, and her shoes are treading on the sun. This is the zeal of the gospel. She is really attached to the word. Tell them to have good heart. The bride is standing upon the sun because she is the moon that represent the church. The church must stand on the sun, and you must establish yourself in the church, preserving in prayer and serving the Lord. People must learn to attend the church, for the bride will always love the gathering in the church. The sun is Jesus and the moon is the church. The moon will be shining like the sun. The bride is founded on the bridegroom. The crown on her head represents authority and insurance. Her shining garment are good works. There is no place for anger, hate, unforgiveness. Her shoe represent the gospel, and the rainbow represent the covenant she has with God. We will not be doing covenant with Jesus in heaven. It must start here. You got to know God here in totality. Speak to him, get close to him here on earth before rising to heaven. The angel asked me, "When you want the man who butcher cattle to give you meat, what will you do?" I said, "I will make a covenant and friendship with him, so that when I want meat I will ask him and he won't refuse because of the covenant." Then the Lord angels told me, "If you don't know a person, you are not close to him and you have no relationship with him. Can he just offer you meat like that? You must have covenant. fellowship and intimacy with Jesus now, so that on the day of the rapture he can remember your dedication to him. Arrange your relationship with him now, not when the trumpets sound, the Lord angels tells me. The color of the rainbow has meaning. Often God people dream colors in the night because they have meaning. Your covenant with God is made up of all the color that is in the rainbow. The rainbow that's around the bride is the covenant between Jesus and believer. This covenant does not begin in heaven but on the earth. Learn to be in a covenant with farmer so that when he killed a cattle you can get some. Make covenant with the Lord and keep the covenant and you will see God. The covenant you have with God is based on the color of the rainbow. Often God speak to you through these colors of the rain for they have meaning. The red color of the rainbow is purification for the bride must keep purifying himself in the blood of the lamb. Yellow color is goodness. Tell the bride to be good to everybody, without categorization and no favoritism. They should not approach only those who are rich and beautiful. They must be good with everybody. The person you neglect can be blessed tomorrow. The blue color is the truth. The gris color is that of humility and humiliation. God did not call us to be celebrity. We must humble ourselves. Pride and scorn are not from God. This is one of the terms of this covenant, in which there is green color, which is joy. We must always be joyful and always praise God whether we are going through test or not. You remember when the Lord angels gave green shoes, to tell me there is unspeakable joy in the word of God, thus glorify God in all circumstances. The orange color is peace, for what the Lord left us is peace. I saw the purple color. The angel said it is prudence. A child of God, even if he is used by God, he must be extremely prudent, for this world is not yours. The devil has conquered it. It belonged to Satan. Thus check the way you dress, the way you talk and the way you deal with others. Even if God is using you powerfully, you must understand that any misstep will give the devil an advantage, an upper hand, to make claim on your soul. All these color of the rainbow put together is white, which is holiness. The church that will be the bride got to have all these color. I was a baby and the Lord was using imagery. When the second pearly gate of the city of light was open, I saw the saints holding one another hand and praying, and the more they pray I saw oil over them, and crowns descended on them. The angels told me, what you see is the image of the bride on the earth united in prayer. God children must be dedicated to fasting and prayer. They must be united in love and one thought, for there should be no division among the redeemed, otherwise they were defeated. Prayer is essential for oil, power and gift of the Spirit. When is division and favoritism in the church? The enemy will dominate. However, unity keep the enemy out, for the enemy is united in destruction. In the church there is complementary. In the third gate I saw a man and woman. This woman was following the man wherever the man went. The angel told me this was the image of the Lord and his church. You need the direction of the bridegroom doing his the bidding. You should not impose God but be conditioned to follow his guidance. The bride must walk with the Lord wherever he goes. We must follow and walk with the Lord. In the fourth of gate the New Jerusalem, I saw two hills, and there was a valley between the two hills. On the first hill was a man, and on top of the second hill, I saw the Lord Jesus Christ, who told the man, come to me, jump the valley and come to me and join me in the highway of the rapture to eternity. The angel told me, the man that is addressed by the Lord represent the church that is on the hill, for a born again believer is like a house built on top of the hill. The believer cannot be below the hill, for he must shine on top of the hill. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a basket. Instead, they set it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. The Lord angels told me, tell the bride of Christ, they must jump the valley of death toward the Lord. A true Christian is on top of the hill shining, and when the trumpet blast he will jump and rise from the earth, which is the valley of death, towards the sky heading to the heavenly mansion. The earth and its wealth and pleasure is the valley of death, that you are supposed to jump from. Tell the believer, they are houses on top of the hill. They cannot hide their action for all will seen. The eyes of the people of the world are upon them. They cannot hide their action. When you think you can sin over there and they won't say you are deceiving yourself.